Do some stuff for yourself. Seriously. Like, there's nothing wrong with doing a little bit of something for yourself. Now, I don't mean going out and buying a Porsche. I mean, if you really want a Porsche, get a Porsche. But I mean doing something for yourself. I'm talking about self-care versus self-indulgence. This is a simple conversation that my sister and I had a couple of weeks ago. And she's been battling with some things, and she brought this up. She's like, I just need to learn to understand the difference between self-care and self-indulgence. And it just clicked. So many people don't really know the difference. So let's talk about the difference really quick, and then talk about maybe some ways that you can start taking care of yourself in a way that's gonna make you feel better. I know this is out of the normal vein of the type of stuff I'm normally doing, but come on, it's all part of health, and it's part of how I help people. It's part of my grand plan to change the world, right? Is understanding this mental side too. You are tuned into the internet's leading performance, nutrition, and fat loss channel. New videos every single Tuesday, Friday, and Sunday. And we're always talking about keto fasting, but occasionally we're talking about things that are just gonna improve your life in general, different ways of looking at life. Please go ahead and hit that red subscribe button, then hit that little bell icon so you can turn on notifications. Also, after you watch this video, I invite you to please check out mud water down below. So the cool thing about mud water is a way for you to get all the energy that you want, but without caffeine. They've utilized a lot of cool things like utilizing cacao. They've utilized some specific adaptogens. Anyway, they're just a really cool company based out of Santa Monica, and they've done some really cool things. So there's a unique opportunity for you to check them out down below in the description before they really make it huge. It's a smaller company that's really just now getting their legs. So check them out down in the description after you watch this video. So now let's go ahead and let's get into some self-care and self-indulgence talk. So self-indulgence. Self-indulgence is just like the name implies. That is doing something that is almost out of control. That is doing something like going out and splurging and spending a bunch of money on yourself for no real inherent reason. Okay, you wake up one day and you're like, I feel like treating myself to a Porsche. I feel like treating myself to something that I really shouldn't be eating. And you do that consistently. That's self-indulgence, it's gluttony. Now, there's a very fine line between gluttony and self-care. Okay, self-care is applying things to your actual health and actual care. Now, let me give you an example that's kind of twisted with me. So much of my business, so much of what I do is based around health, right? So it makes it really difficult to actually have an element of self-care, to spend money on myself for things that are actually helping my health or helping me get better at something. Because it's all kind of circulating through this ecosystem of business. So it's like, even if I make a choice here for my exercise or a choice there for a massage or whatever to feel better, it's really hard and it doesn't feel like self-care because it's still within the ecosystem of my business. So sometimes I have to go out and I have to do things that are outside of the realm of health. You know, for example, I've been learning to fly a helicopter. That's something that's really fun for me. And it's out of the normal realm of what I would do. That is self-care because it's enriching. Where it becomes self-indulgence is when you go and you get something material. So if I said to myself, oh, okay, I'm tired of the same old exercise, I'm tired of the same old routine that's health-oriented, I wanna do something different, and I go out and I say, I'm just gonna buy something material, I'm gonna go buy a Ferrari today, or I'm just gonna go out and buy something new, I'm gonna go to the mall and buy something really cool. That is a perfect example of self-indulgence. It's sporadic, it's spur of the moment, it doesn't mean anything, and it's going to fade. Anything material fades, okay? We all know that. We know that materialism isn't the way to happiness, okay? Most of us know that. I'm preaching to the choir, okay? But what you do have to understand in what I'm trying to instill upon you is that it is okay to spend money on self-care, okay? So many people don't spend money on self-care because they get it misconstrued with self-indulgence. So what you need to do is you need to become very clear with yourself on what is self-care and be very honest on what self-care and what self-indulgence is. Because if you don't spend the money on self-care, you cannot be your best self and you cannot ever be happy and you cannot do the things that you really want to do in life. So for example, if you are someone that is in pain, you should spend the money on getting a massage. It's not self-indulgence. That's where the lines get crossed. We see so much conflicting information that tells us if we go out and we get a massage that we are spoiling ourselves, we're pampering ourselves. Or if you're a female and you go out and you have a spa day, your friends might say, oh, it's so good that you pampered yourself. That doesn't feel good actually, right? Like deep down, you're kind of like, I feel guilty because I shouldn't be out pampering myself. I should be, you know, contributing to my family. I should be taking care of my kids. I should be with my kiddo, not going out and getting pampered, right? Those little subtle cues and those labels that get put upon us whenever we spend a little bit of money on our self-care, those mess us up and they royally screw us up. They make us feel like we can never invest in ourselves. So you need to set a plan and be very disciplined about that. Because honestly, that's the only way that you're going to be able to have the success that you want in life. For me, I find myself getting into a rut over and over and over again. And I find out that I end up having injuries because I'm in that same rut. So the second that I get outside of my box and I spend a little bit of money doing something that feels good, maybe it is spending the extra money on some physical therapy that I normally wouldn't. Maybe it is spending the extra money on going to therapy once or twice a month and actually talking to somebody. It's not spoiling yourself or pampering yourself. It's applying principles that are really going to make you feel better. And sometimes buying a roll of duct tape to tape your life together costs a couple bucks. So my point in saying this is don't be afraid to spend money on yourself if it's going to allow you to be better at what you do. Don't let the labels that people put on you for spoiling yourself be completely misconstrued into thinking that everything you do is spoiling yourself. Okay, guys, if you need to spend a couple bucks on allowing yourself the freedom to work on your car in the garage now and then, you should do that because that is an element of self-care. Studies have shown time after time after time that people that participate in things that they love outside of their normal realm or ecosystem of work are significantly happier, have significantly better relationships, have significantly longer marriages, and have significantly lower levels of depression, lower levels of suicide, but their overall rates of happiness are significantly higher. I know that's a lot of significantlies, right? Then you have the old study on Reese's monkeys. I can't remember where it was, but it took a look at monkeys and it found that, like, really there was no change in their lifestyle unless there was just different elements of their social life that were changed. So they could have more food, less food, nothing happened to their happiness more so than what was changed when they had different social elements. Then there's other economic studies that show that the difference between someone that makes just enough money to have their basic needs met in terms of happiness compared to someone that makes 10 times above and beyond that is negligible. Once your basic needs are met, all you need to focus on is doing things that make you happy. Okay? Now, travel is a gray area. I wanted to address this because some people are going to say, well, I travel. That's my form of self-care. Travel to some degree needs to be measured as like a finite amount of self-indulgence, right? You can have that travel, but you don't want to lean on travel as being your element of self-care. Some people are wired like that where they need to see different parts of the world all the time to get that element of self-care. But self-care is a little bit more direct and applied. What are you doing right now investing in yourself? Okay. Travel, unfortunately, some of that still wanes. Now, that's more of a refresher. That's what you need as a recharger. It's not a form of self-care, in my opinion. When you go travel and you exercise an element of self-care, that's when it applies. So for example, if you go and you travel to Hawaii, traveling itself is going to be mind expanding. It's going to be good. But then what are you going to do for self-care while you're there? Okay, maybe you go and you get a massage. Maybe you go and you spend the money on some personal training sessions that are going to get you further to your goal. You have to spend money on yourself. That's all there is to it. And I guess that's just the impetus of this. My sister was hesitant to spend money on herself. I've always been hesitant to spend money on myself because it feels like we're spoiling ourselves. We have the underlying sense of guilt, but do it. But don't buy material things. Just go ahead and get the self-care that you need to feel like the best possible version of yourself, but also be the best possible version of yourself. So let this just be a simple reminder for you. As always, keep it locked in here on my channel, and I'll see you in the next video.